ADHD and dyslexia, we know that there's a high overlap. Usually, if you look at any child with ADHD, about 20 to 40% will also have dyslexia or LD, learning differences. And then if you look at children with LD or dyslexia, then those children will also, maybe about up to 40% of the children will have ADHD, in particular the attention deficit subtype. So that's what's known from the prevalence rate in the research literature. And then if you look at the characteristics, it's quite interesting. So I said that dyslexia often has attention deficit subtypes, but then you start looking at the brain, and then most of the brain research, there's not that many, but if you look at them, the dyslexia research is focused on the language area and the left side of the brain, often on the back side of the brain. That's important for phonological processing, orthographic, the visual aspects, sound aspects, and connections between those, which is usually on the left back side of the brain. But then ADHD often focus on the front side of the brain that deals with executive function, organizational skills, and response inhibition when you need to, and flexibility and these things. So there's a large disconnect in the literature right now, and hardly anyone has looked at the overlap between ADHD and dyslexia, even though there's many of them. But if you look at the genetics, there seem to be some genetic overlap in it. So that would suggest that we need approaches to both at the same time. But we also often know that if you have ADHD, then you could end up having dyslexia-like symptoms because you're not going to like schooling and you're going to act out or have hyperactivity maybe in the schools. But then also if you have dyslexia, even though you don't have ADHD necessarily, then you will end up having ADHD-like symptoms. So there's both these factors kind of interacting. And so I think with more research, hopefully people can identify how to really get at one or the other without necessarily over-treating if you don't need to. Because, for example, if you treated dyslexia or if you had the right support for dyslexia, maybe you won't need the ADHD medication, for example. But some kids might really help from both. And so I think hopefully research will bring us to that level where we have the sensitivity to be able to really say which one's a chicken or egg and when we need the support for both. Thank you.